okej om jag tar en bild? Är det okej om jag tar en bild? Vad heter den? Uffe. Ursäkta. Hej. Jag är ute och tar lite... Jag vill ut och ta lite porträtt. Skulle jag kunna få take picture with me?
All right. So, welcome back to the channel, guys. It's been quite a while, as per usual, and I'm sorry, as per usual. I think I mentioned in my previous video this summer that that's gonna be my tagline from now on, because I say it every time, and it's true every time. It's been exactly 1 year on the day since I recorded my Asking Strangers for Portraits in Stockholm, where I went around with the GoPro and asked strangers if I could take portraits of them. And I figured I'd do something similar today, basically. It's gonna be slightly a different concept though. I figured instead of asking people for portraits, I'm gonna take this time to actually tell you guys about my story this year, but why I haven't been uploading, what happened, because I mean, the last thing you heard was that I was going all in for YouTube videos, and I mean, if you check my YouTube channel, you can see that that didn't happen. So I'm just gonna walk around with the GoPro, taking street photography and talking to you guys at the same time, basically. And I think we shouldn't waste any more time, because it's Sweden, it's winter, it's gonna be dark in about an hour, so we better get going.
Det var nästan så det såg ut som att fågeln gick med dig där. Det var nästan det såg ut som att du var ute och gick med fågeln också. Den gick bredvid dig så här.
Det är min tamfågel.
Är det det? Är det så på riktigt?
De väntar ibland utanför min port.
Nej.
Det är en gammal hane och så en hona.
Jaha.
De håller ju ihop hela livet.
Är det så?
Så att jag har bytt hund en gång.
Jaha. Jag är ute och tar lite bilder. Kan man ta en bild på hunden kanske?
Ja.
Vad heter den? Uffe.
Han är helt döv.
Han är helt döv, ja. Då är det ingen idé att ropa då. Hej! Ja, vad fin du var då. Hej!
Ja,
men jag tycker det blev rätt bra. Ja, verkligen. Jag har en kompis med hundar. Det är ingen idé att ens försöka.
Är du yrkesfotograf eller?
Ja, jag fotar i dentalbranschen, men nu är jag ute. Dental, tandläkare och sånt där. Så jag brukar fota munnar, eller inte hellre, men oftast. Men nu är jag ute på skoj bara, så att... Oh, men det är vi för att marknadsföra, så tar vi bilder och utbilda och sådär. Så att när man går till tandläkaren så står inte jag där, men... Vad sa du?
Jag får vackra tänder som lockar.
Ja, men tack så mycket. Ha en bra dag. Hej då. All right. That was a cute dog. She mentioned it was deaf, so there was no point trying to call for it. And I have AirPods in my ears, so that people are not gonna think that I'm crazy walking around talking to myself. But yeah, I don't know where to start. I figured it would be a good time to talk about everything that happened to me this year, since it's quite a lot and it's hard to cover, and most of all it's pretty boring to just sit down in a chair and talk about it. So I figured I could just walk around, bring you guys on a tour of Stockholm, and take pictures at the same time. Alright, so for most people, unfortunately, this year has probably been like one of the worst. And for me, that's definitely not the case. I would actually say that this has probably been like the best year in my entire life, to be honest. And I have never been this happy, and I'm gonna tell you all about it. And hopefully it can inspire you a bit as well, if you're a struggling freelancer or photographer or something. And it started in the beginning of the year. Just a normal beginning, January, February, nothing special. I was still in the, like, my plan was to go all in for freelancing and photography and my own business and stuff. And that's basically what I did. I was working very little at my day job, and just trying to have a lot of time for photography and clients. And turns out it's not as easy as they make it sound like in these crazy New York style you can do it videos, because there was no clients to be found. And it wasn't due to Corona or anything, it was just that you need a lot of clients to be able to get food on the table every month. And yeah, I guess I just didn't realize how hard it was going to be. So basically, the only thing that happened when I decided to go all in for photography was that I became completely broke and kind of almost depressed. A lot of anxiety about money, because it's really bad feeling when you feel like your money situation is not in a good place. And I guess you've realized already, but this video is going to be a lot of rambling, so just be ready for that. Especially since I'm going to interrupt myself all the time with taking photos. But yeah, I was in a really bad place in the start of the year, and in the end of last year as well. Ever since I got home from my Asia trip, I've been in a really bad place. Or I was in a really bad place. When was the turning point? Right, so a little backstory. I don't want auto white balance. I want to use. ...6,000 is gonna be good. We actually have some pretty good skies here. Look at this, that's beautiful. Alright, so yeah, I was in a pretty bad place economically, and that's not in a place you want to be when you want to be excited about YouTube videos and stuff. All my YouTube videos that I made back then basically felt like I had to do it, and it was not good at all. So what happened is, in the end of last year, I had a videography gig. A guy commented on one of my videos and asked me if I was looking for work, and he found me through the comments of a different YouTube video. So basically, I just commented on a guy's video, and this dentist found me, and he commented on my video and said, email me if you're looking for work, basically. And I said, Well, I emailed him and we got to talking, and it turns out he had a clinic here in Stockholm and he wanted to shoot like a promo video for his clinic. And I helped him out to shoot that video. Maybe I can show you some bits and pieces of it right here. And so yeah, I shot that video for him and I charged a certain price. And that's the thing as well, when you're starting out and you feel like you need every single gig, it's really hard to put some pricing, because even if you're in a very big need of cash, you're so afraid to lose the job that you usually underprice yourself, because you don't want them to go to someone else. You really want the job. And he obviously didn't tell me at that point, but he felt like I undercharged him a lot. And yeah, the months went by, because this was in like November, December. And after that, the months went by. And I think somewhere in January, he contacted me and asked me if I was looking for a job, like a real job at a company that he had been working at before. And I told him that I'm 100% interested. Okay, so this is gonna be sketchy. Whoa! Whoa! It was slippery as hell. I need to get a better vantage point. Anyways, he contacted me and said, "Hey man, I have the perfect job for you. I worked at this place, a place where they manufacture dental products and instruments and stuff like that. And they need someone who can do their digital marketing and create content for them, and you would be the perfect fit." And I was like, wow, definitely, I'm interested, let's go. This is good. I'm 100% interested, let's go, is what I told him. And the months went by again, 1 or 2 months, and then I went on my interview and I got that job. And yeah, like I mentioned, they wanted me to do digital marketing, photography, videography, shooting dental products, and I was kind of expecting somewhere where people are walking around with like white coats at like a lab or something. But turns out it's like the best place ever, with the best colleagues, and everyone is so nice, and I'm working with a team with another person. And yeah, it's just, I don't really know what to say about it. It's just great. It's really great. Wow, this is beautiful. Look at this view, guys. Stockholm. Okay, let's keep going. It's really slippery here. Funny story, actually. About 2 weeks ago, I woke up at like 5 in the morning to go to this exact location and shoot, like fly some drone and shoot time lapse and stuff. And I drove the car in the morning. I came to this exact location and realized that I didn't have any memory cards in either the drone or the camera. So that was a good time. Look at this view. I hope you can see. I don't know, I didn't really check where the GoPro is pointing. Anyways, I kind of want to stick around there, but at the same time I want to keep moving because I know the sun is going to go down soon. Okay, let's use this. It's getting so beautiful. All right, let's keep going. But yeah, I don't know where I was. Yeah, I have this awesome job creating content for a dental company, and I shoot photos and take videos and everything is great and I love it. And I also met a beautiful, beautiful girl who is my girlfriend. And everything is just perfect. So 2020 for me was new job, new car, amazing girlfriend. And yeah. I guess the only thing that is not good is that I stopped recording YouTube videos. And the reason for it is that I don't have time. Like literally don't have time, enough time in the day to create YouTube videos. And when the weekend comes around, like even if I love filmmaking and stuff, I create content all during the week. So the first thing I want to do in the weekend is not to like start editing, even though it's personal projects, because it's just, I don't know, I want to spend time with my girlfriend and do other stuff when the weekend comes around. So it's basically in these times when I'm on a vacation or a holiday or something, that's when the motivation comes back to shoot videos, which is what I'm doing right now. But, yeah, so that's the story about that. And, I don't know, like, I don't know what my plan is with YouTube right now. I guess it's just gonna be to upload as much as I can. Like, obviously, okay, so, in a normal week, I go to work at, like, 7, and I come home at around maybe 5-6 at the earliest, and I also want to get a workout in every day, so, or almost every day, so that's like, with those hours it's really hard to create YouTube videos, but I really want to find a way to do it. And I guess maybe I'm gonna have to do it like every other weekend, or maybe shoot footage and then edit it a little bit piece by piece, but I don't know how exactly I'm gonna make it work. And yeah, I figured it was gonna take like an hour to tell this story, but I'm already finished, so what the hell am I gonna talk about now? I guess we'll just keep walking and you can enjoy some music instead. I feel like I missed something though. Nope. Or well, yeah, I kind of wanted to mention, or I kind of wanted to talk about. Oh, we have a Teams meeting down here. Hello. I wanted to talk about the fact that I managed to land a really awesome job with a good pay and doing something that I love. And it all happened through a comment on YouTube. And the funny part is that when I put that comment on that guy's feed, I was thinking to myself that, man, I need to be more active on YouTube. I need to start commenting on other people's videos and interacting with the community. And in the end, like one of those comments on the day where I had like a little comment session landed me this job, because this dentist saw me there and he needed the video and he was like, contact me, and one thing led to another, and he thought that I was a really nice guy and a humble guy, and all of this accumulated into a job, which is really awesome. And I hope it can inspire you a little bit, because I was really like, none of this would have happened if I didn't do my little like all-in videographer photographer thing. Because I mean, yeah, you gotta hit the bottom to reach the top, or something cliche like that. I think you know what I mean, guys. And let's try to get some photos instead. Oh, there's actually a thing I wanted to see, and I think it's over here. Just so you know, guys, I haven't been out shooting photos since, I don't even know, the last time. So I'm also kind of not in my best. I'm not in my prime. Yeah, I'm not in my prime, but I'm trying. Maybe you think it's a lot of people out to be COVID-19, but I don't know. I haven't even noticed anything. I mean, of course I've noticed a difference during the pandemic, but it's not been like crazy different like I heard it's been in other parts of Europe. It's much easier to ask if you can take a photo of somebody's dog. Kan man ta en bild? Kan man ta en bild på hunden?
Ja.
Det där, ja. Vad heter den?
Luna.
Luna. Hej Luna. Ja. Hej Luna. Vad fin.
Är det bra?
Ja då.
Ja, det var fint.
Ja.
Vad ska du ha den till?
Jag är ute och filmar en YouTube-video där jag bara fotar lite och så här går runt. Ja. Du vill inte vara med på bild? Nej. Tack så mycket. I gave it a shot, guys. I gave it a shot. I'm actually thinking of switching to the 90mm 2.8 soon. Because, yeah, I want to try it out. I don't do a lot of wide-angle photography at all, actually. Probably should do more. That's a nice car. So the sun is gonna go down in 20 minutes from now. I feel kind of stressed, not gonna lie. I don't know. That water pool was maybe a bit too small, to be honest. I feel like I'm not finding any people. Got a cool guy here at the bike. Är okej om jag tar en bild? Är okej om jag tar en bild? Snyggt. Schysst. That's what we like. I think I'm starting to get into it again. Just ask and you shall receive. Most of the time. Starting to get dark actually. And the place I wanted to see, I thought it would have been somewhere around here. Maybe it's further down. Hejsan. Hej. Jag är ute och fotograferar lite. Är det okej om jag tar en bild? Går det bra? Det är bara, jag är bara ute och gör det för skojs skull. Ja. Tack så mycket. Ha en bra dag. You could see that I was skeptical of asking, but she was down. So, yeah. Out taking some fresh air. I'm trying not to talk too much about the whole corona thing in this video because I feel like that's all you hear about anyway, so I don't wanna rant on about it, but yeah, obviously it sucks and not much to do about it. Okay, so now I know where we are and we're starting to get to where I wanted to be, where there is a big nice thing. That I'm gonna show you. Here we have a big water pool, maybe we can do something, or is it too dirty maybe? I'm not really big on water pool photography stuff, but people seem to like it, so... Wow, that's so big, that boat. Oh my god, that sounded strange, but I mean the bokeh, it was really big. Wow! Okay, so... just a little bit further. I think they removed it. No. It was like a big poster on the wall that said, "We will hug again." And I thought it was kind of nice, like, they meant that we will hug again after this pandemic is over. And it was up on that wall before, I think. But it seems like they removed it. That was a cute little kiosk over there. See if we can get to the middle of the street. So I'm quickly gonna pause the recording and put on the 90mm. So be right back. Alright, so the GoPro is actually really low on battery. I don't know for how much longer it's gonna be able to record. But yeah, I'm gonna keep going. I should have extra GoPro batteries for next time. It's actually not even my GoPro, it's my friend's that I'm borrowing. It's actually a macro lens, so let's see how close we can go. Pretty close. I think it's so hard to see which people are gonna say yes to be photographed. I was gonna take a shot of that guy, but the white balance was completely off. And I could have changed it in post, but now I was just being stupid. Shout out to Volvo, Swedish manufacturer. Sorry for being weird. Got another dog coming up, but I'm not gonna go for that one because we already have too many doggies. Ja, en fin kruka fick hon då. Det var ju gulligt. See what we have here. I was hoping that you would be able to go down. Got somebody up to no good up here. What have you done? Three cops and one guy. Hej, kan man ta en bild?
Ja.
Ja, okej. He was not in the mood. Ursäkta. Hej. Jag är ute och tar lite porträtt. Skulle jag kunna få take picture when you have the
yes?
Can stand facing like this. Perfect. I can come a bit closer. Really cool.
Nice, beautiful.
Thank you, man. All right, so the batteries in the GoPro just ran out. I'm making my way back to the car, and I mean, it was kind of a decent session, I think. Didn't get that many shots, but I asked a few people and I talked a little bit about what's been going on with me, and yeah, overall I feel like it was a good sesh. I'm gonna upload a story right now asking if you want this video to be completely like uncut, or if you want me to... Why am I always vlogging in like stairs or uphill? I'm gonna upload an Insta story right now asking if you want this video to be completely uncut, or if I should remove the parts where I'm just like toddling around doing nothing. Cause I feel like maybe it's boring to watch that, but at the same time it's kinda cozy to see it just as it was. But yeah. Anyways guys, that was the end of this video, and I hope to see you in the next one, and none of us have any idea when that's gonna be, so peace out and have a good Christmas and New Year's and all that good stuff.